ISUPK.
Commanding General Yohana. The ISUPK is not affiliated with any religious group or organization. Tonight we're going to let you know that the Christian Church is not telling you the truth according to the Bible. We're also going to let you know that the God you serve is not a God of hugs and kisses.
Right.
Give me what you have.
The book of Romans, chapter 6. And verse 23.
What?
For the wages of sin is death.
For what?
The wages of sin is death.
When we sin against the Most High, we're going to die. When we sin against God,
right,
we are going to die.
Right.
The scripture lets you know, for the wages of sin is death.
Right.
And then we'll be asking ourselves, what's happening here? What's happening there? What's happening to our family members? And we don't understand, but we sin against God, he pulls the plug. Right? Give me First John. Give me Salakia. Give me First John 3 and 4. We must understand the power that we serve. We must understand when we wake in the morning and we turn on the TV, we turn on the news, we see what's happening, we're going to understand what's happening around us. Go ahead, read.
The book of First John,
right?
Chapter 3 and verse 4.
Wait.
Whosoever committed sin.
Whosoever what?
Committed sin.
What?
Transgresseth also the law.
So when you break the laws of this book, of this Bible, you're committing sin. You are committing sin when you break the laws in this Bible. And your Christian pastor is going to tell you what? The laws are done away with. And we go around crazy or willy-nilly doing what the hell we want and don't understand that the Most High is waiting right here to do what? To jack you up. Give me Deuteronomy 32 and 9.
Sure.
And when he jacked you up, we don't know what's happening. So we start questioning, why did Mark do this? Why did Paul do this? Why did Stacy do this? Are we not understanding that it's not Mark, it's not Paul, it's not Stacy, but the Most High God? Go ahead, read.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32 and verse 29.
Go ahead.
See now.
See now. Go ahead.
That I, I'm he, and there is no God with me.
Right, go ahead.
I kill.
What?
I kill.
What?
I kill.
The Most High lets you know he kills.
That's right.
The God that we serve, he kills.
That's right.
And the Christian church and your so-called wicked pastor is not going to let you know that God kills.
Right.
Take it from the top again.
The book of Deuteronomy,
wait,
chapter 32 and verse 39.
Wait, read.
See now that I, even I, am he, and there is no God with me.
Wait.
I kill.
I what?
I kill.
I what?
I kill.
Wait.
And make alive.
And make alive. The Most High power that we serve kills, and he makes alive.
Right.
When you see people falling down on the street because why? They're being shot. They're being knocked down. They're being hit by stray bullets. Guess what? The Most High is calling the shots.
Right.
The Most High knows that you are sinning against him. And guess what? He's going to call you home. John and pulling the trigger to call you home. Mark and pushing back your wig to call you home. Ain't nobody sinning your home. The Most High God is the one pulling the shot. Go ahead, read.
I kill.
Go ahead.
and I make alive. Mm-hmm. I womb.
I what?
I womb.
Even the smallest thing like a goddamn womb. The most I let you know that he does it. Where we?
And I heal.
And you what?
I heal.
And when you end up in a goddamn hospital because you're breaking the laws of God, guess what?
I heal.
He's going to heal you.
That's right.
And give you that chance to go again.
That's
and
right.
Give you that chance to repent. And to give you that chance to come back and do what? Keep the laws of the Most High power.
Right.
Give me Job chapter 1 verse 6. You must understand that the God we serve is not a God of hugs and kisses.
Right.
Go ahead, read.
The book of Job chapter 1 and verse 6.
When?
No, there was a day when the sons of God.
And the what?
Sons of God.
The sons of God. Is the angels, go ahead, read.
That's came right. To present themselves before the Lord.
They did what?
Present themselves before the Lord.
So the angels come to present themselves before the Lord. Go ahead, read.
And Satan.
And who?
And Satan.
And who?
And Satan.
Go ahead.
Came also among them.
And guess what? Satan came also among them.
Right.
The Christian church, have you believe in what? That Satan is the one calling the shots. That Satan and God, they are in war. But guess what? Satan works for God.
That's right. Now there was a day
when
the sons of God
right.
came to present themselves before the Lord.
Right.
And Satan came also among them.
When?
And the Lord said unto Satan.
And the Lord said what?
Whence comest thou?
And the Lord said what?
Whence comest thou?
Guess what? The Lord is talking to Satan on accident. Where are you coming from? Because they came to present themselves before him. Go ahead, read.
Then Satan answered the Lord and said.
Then Satan what?
Answered the Lord and said.
Now if Satan was at war with God, why are you answering God? Why are you answering God?
Right.
Your Christian pastor is not going to teach you these things.
That's right.
And he's going to have you walking up and down,
that's
doing
right.
as you please, not knowing you're sinning against the Most High God. And guess what? He's waiting to jack you up. Go ahead, read.
Then Satan answered the Lord and said,
go ahead.
From going to and fro in the earth.
From doing what?
Going to and fro in the earth.
So Satan now is up and down, everywhere you can think about. Doing what? Tempting you to go against God. Tempting you to stop, keep the laws of the Most High.
Right.
Tempting you to smoke. Tempting you to commit adultery. Tempting you to do all the things that the Most High God said, don't do.
That's right.
The Christian pastor is not going to tell you, when you sin against God, you are going to die.
Right.
Go ahead, read.
From going to and fro in the earth.
Go ahead.
And from walking up and down in it.
Go ahead.
And the Lord said unto Satan.
And the Lord said what?
And the Lord said unto Satan.
Go ahead.
Hast thou considered my servant Job?
Guess what? The Lord said, Satan, have you considered my servant Job? Now we got to ask ourselves this question. If the Most High says, Satan, have you considered Paul and Silas? Have you considered Matthew in Point 14?
Right.
Have you considered Jeremiah in Tobago?
Right.
Guess, go ahead, read.
And the Lord said unto Satan,
what?
Hast thou considered my servant Job?
What?
That there is none like him in the earth.
That there is what?
There is none like him in the earth.
What?
A perfect and upright man.
Right. So Job now was a perfect and upright man to the Most High. He ain't doing no sin. He committing adultery. He's sleeping with his neighbor's wife. He's smoking cocaine. He's smoking weed. He's smoking cigarettes. Go ahead, read.
One that feareth God.
One that fear God. And to fear God, you gotta do what? Keep his commandments.
That's right.
That's right.
You gotta keep his laws. That's how you fear the Most High.
That's
right. The Most High don't want you running in a corner and hiding. And I fear God. He just wants you to keep his laws.
That's right.
Don't smoke weed. Don't set crack to your brothers. Don't sleep with your neighbor's wife. Don't eat pork, crab, shrimp, and lobster. Go ahead, read.
And eschew it evil.
Go ahead.
Then Satan answered the Lord and said.
Then Satan what?
Answered the Lord and said.
Go ahead.
And said, do a Job fear God for naught?
So Satan is asking, do Job fear you for nothing? Go ahead. Stop it up at 12.
Go ahead. Has not thou made a hedge around him?
So Satan is telling the Most High, guess what? Have you not made a hedge around Job? You know, like Trinidadian terms, we like to say, you ain't have a fence around Job. That is what Satan is asking God.
Right.
Have you not, go ahead, read it from the top.
Has not thou made a hedge about him?
Go ahead.
And about his house.
Guess what? Job, being faithful of the Most High, serving the Most High, is doing what? Being protected by God. And Satan is saying, so if you're protecting God, guess what? Go ahead, read.
Has thou not made a hedge about him?
What?
And about his house?
What?
And about all he had on every side?
Go ahead, read.
Thou hast blessed the work of his hands.
Go ahead.
And his substance is increased.
So God has blessed Job, increasing substance, because he is serving the Most High. Go ahead, read.
But put forth thine hand
but
now.
What?
Put forth thine hand
so
now.
So Satan is asking God, hear what? Give me a chance. Put forth your hand. Give me the permission. Go ahead, read.
And touch all that he had.
Give me the permission to touch Job. Satan is asking God for the permission to touch all that Job has.
Right.
Go ahead, read.
And he will curse thee to thy face.
And guess what? Satan is saying, once I touch it, he's going to curse you to his face. He's not going to serve you. This is the ISUPK under Commanding General Lehana. The ISUPK is not affiliated with any religious group.
Right.
This is my time for the Spain. Shalom.
We want